Thanks everyone for joining. In today's session, we are gonna actually do the second and third exercise in Copilot Developer Camp. My name is Ayça. I'm a cloud developer advocate. And if you've never heard of Copilot Developer Camp, we've been doing series for the community calls in the past couple of weeks. My colleagues and I were showing you how you can build the exercises. So we were basically doing the exercises together in the community calls. In today's session in particular, we are focusing on custom engine agents. In our last session in custom engine agents, we covered how you can get started building your first custom engine agent using Teams Toolkit. And we are going to follow up where we left off, and we will just continue building on top of what we already have. So without losing any time, let's just go ahead and get started. Okay, so we are in Copilot Developer Camp, and this session is about build path, where we have build custom engine agent. In the last session, I covered how you can build your first custom engine agent. So this session is going to be about B2 and B3, where we integrate our custom engine agent with Azure AI Search, and next, enhancing the user experience using some of the Teams AI library capabilities. So in the B2, what we're going to do actually, we're going to create Azure resources, one of which Azure AI Search, and the other one is this storage account where we're going to use blob storage. And then we will create text embedding ADA model to be able to use vector search in our custom engine agent. We will upload some of resumes so that our career genie agent will be able to help us find the right candidate for our job description. So let's, without going any details in the text, I just want to show you how you can actually do that on Azure. So I already created these resources. So last week, we've already seen how you can create Azure OpenAI and how you can get to work with OpenAI on AI Foundry. And this week, we have two more resources. One is search and another one is the storage. So by using these two, we are going to actually create a data source together, and then we will connect this in our custom engine agent. Okay, so as you know from the previous session, if you go into OpenAI, Azure OpenAI resource, then there is an option in the overview where you can go to the AI Foundry. And if you click to that, you will be directed to Azure AI Foundry. So my resource, Azure OpenAI, is selected here. And I just want to show you one important thing, which are the deployment models. If you go to deployment models, you will be able to see all of the created deployment models available. So we created GPT-4o last week to be able to use in our custom engine agent. And this week, we are going to also use text embedding ADA model to be able to vectorize our data and to be able to use vector search with our data. So if you want to create those from scratch, you just need to click on deploy, deploy base model, and then you can search the name of the model, hit confirm, and you'll be able to create it right away. So let's go to chat first, which is the chat playground, and create our data set in Azure AI Search, and then move on by testing everything in chat. So I'll select add your data. There's an option called add a data source. In this session, so if you follow Copilot Developer Camp, you will be you guided to select upload files, and then you're going to have to select blob storage, Azure AI search resource, and I'm going to share that very quickly. And then you will have to provide the name of your index once it's loaded. Resumes, I already have resumes, so I'm going to just select resumes too. And we need to select add vector search to this search resource. That means that we're enabling vector search in our data set. That actually means, I'm going to show you in a second, it creates a vector content in addition to our text content. In that case, we are able to not just do keyword search, but on top of everything, we are able to do vector search, which means we are able to get data in relevance instead of getting the data directly word by word. So you can read more in our Copilot Developer Camp labs, but that actually means that even if you don't have complaint, let's say, in the documents, With vector search, we are able to identify if there is a complaint in the document so that you're able to retrieve the related data out of it. So it's kind of a really advanced search experience. I'm going to select my embedding model here. And then next is just selecting all of the files we have available. And these are all the resumes, 35 resumes we have. And it's uploading the files. Next, you have to select search type. For this demo, we will select vector and keyword together. And we will keep the size as default. We will choose API key as the authentication type. And then it will start indexing our data in our Azure AI search. So what it does behind the scenes, actually, it indexes the entire chat playground, literally indexes our data in Azure AI search. So when data ingestion happens, when it comes to testing the same data next time, you don't have to upload the files again because your data will be available in Azure AI search right away. So if you go to Azure AI search and it happens every time to me. So there is an invisible button over there. I keep clicking. I'll put it like that. Okay, so there we go. We uploaded all of the files magically. And if you select the index, it will guide you to Azure AI search where all the data is indexed. That means that our data source, basically all of the files we uploaded were uploaded to Blob Storage and data is indexed in Azure AI search and made it available for vector search experience for us. So resumes too, and before I jump into showing you how our data looks like, I just want to quickly show you what is available in the fields. So if we scroll down, there's something called content vector. So when I select this and save this, I will be able to see the content vector in my search explorer as well. Without writing anything, I'll just hit search to be able to see all the data we have. And we have some resumes, as I mentioned earlier. So we have chunked ID, parent ID, content itself, which is multi-language resumes we have available. So we have in Dutch, Arabic, Turkish, all of the different languages available, very diverse. And the same data, the same content is also available as content vector. That means that our search experience is not through text anymore. It's through vector. It is actually numeric. That means that we are not in the field of basically doing the search in a, let's say, English language or Turkish language. It's all about finding the relevant information from the vector data set available. So in that case, now, what we are using in the chat playground is directly the data set we have in Azure AI search. Once you connect this, once you uploaded all of your files, you will be able to test out everything. And I will get a great question from our exercises because we usually test these with a very long question. Yep. Can you suggest me a candidate who is suitable for a Spanish-speaking role that requires at least 2 years of .NET experience? So this is sort of a complex question. And the data set we have available, because we are enabling vector search, we should be able to get a really good answer. And as you see, we are able to get some suggestions out of the data set we have. What I want to do further is I want to connect this data set in Azure AI search, my index, directly into custom engine agent. Okay, so I hope you get a good understanding of how Azure AI search works behind the scene. Next step for us is basically bringing this Azure AI search experience into our custom engine agent. You may remember this app I've created in the last community call from scratch using Teams Toolkit. In this session, we will basically add Azure AI search integration in our custom engine agent. Okay, so let's get started. The first thing I need to do is I actually need to go to env.local.user where I need to add my data sources. So a couple of things I need to include here, and I've already did, that's why I'm not clicking, so I don't want you to see my keys. But four things I've included in my env.local.user. The first one is the embedding deployment name, where we use for vector search. The second is the search key, third search endpoint, and then finally index name, which is going to be resumes two for us in the session. So I've already added all those. So for us to be able to make this work with Teams Toolkit, we need some sort of a configuration set up in Teams app.local.yaml. So I will just need to add all of these in the local YAML file as well. And right after that, we should go to config.ts. And to be able to use all of these keys in our app, we should also add all of the four keys we've included in our env file in the config.ts too. So next step for us is actually integrating the data source, which is Azure AI Search. So if you go to prompt/chat config.json, this is the place where we're going to add the data source. And I've already added that just to make sure we have enough time to go through everything. The data sources covers all of the data sources we want to include in our custom engine agent. In this case, our data source type is Azure AI Search. And everything, all of the endpoint, index name, search key, etc., are coming from the config that we've just added. And in addition to that, our search experience is going to be vector type. So the query is going to be in vector. Once you've included that, there will be small changes needed in the prompt that we've added last in the first session we've had. I've just added one line here just to make sure that always mention all citations in your content. And after I customize the prompt, next step for us is app.ts. So let's see what changes we have to make in app.ts to be able to make Azure AI Search together with my custom engine agent. First, we need to add FS. So I've already installed FS, and we are going to use that just to make sure that we are able to use our configuration and basically environment variables we've just added, the four of them, as you remember. Next, we need to add Azure API version to make this example work with the relevant version. And by the way, you'll be able to find all these steps in our labs too. I'm just making sure that we don't lose any time so that I'm moving a bit quickly. Next step, and I will walk you through what this means, we are updating default prompt inside the planner. That means that now default prompt is not only chat, where we have chat, config.json, etc. But chat, obviously, as you remember, we need all of these environment variables to be able to make the Azure AI Search work. So to be able to do that, we are basically passing all of the keys from app.ts to the config.json by just using data sources, and we are passing the parameters we've already had in the config. And with that, we should be able to try out the same experience on Microsoft Teams. So what this actually does is, just to summarize what I just did, I basically added four environment variables in the local.user, and I added everything in the config.ts to be able to use Azure AI Search in the embedding model. I pass all of the parameters from default prompt, and then next step is just getting the configuration done in config.json, and it should just work fine with the setup. Hopefully when it provisions, we will jump into the tab. I already have it open. Perfect. Okay, I don't need this. I already have something open. Okay, this is our agent. As you can imagine, I tested this before the commit call. So let's try the same example we've just tried earlier. Oh, maybe we should say hi before, right? Just to be kind. Be kind to agents, everyone. It's important. Yes, so we get the same behavior as we did in the first session. Let's ask the same question now and see if we get similar experience with the chat playground we just tested this question to. Yeah, Yeah, so we get a good recommendation, and as if I hover over, I'm able to see the citation as well. So we are able to retrieve data from Azure AI Search. Just quickly, this will take 2 to 3 minutes, I promised to Vesa. There's also the follow-up lab that I want to quickly talk about, which is enhancing the user experience. And it's all about using some capabilities Teams AI Library provides, like feedback loop, enhanced citations with adaptive cards, also generated by AI label, sensitivity label, and all. Some of them are already coming as default to with the templates Teams Toolkit provides. For example, we already have thumbs up, thumbs down that is integrated in our source code. If you quickly go ahead and have a look, you will see that enable feedback loop is equal to true already in our app. So that means that if we want to actually get something or retrieve something or send something using thumbs up, thumbs down, we are able to do that. I'll quickly test that for you. And submit. So this should give us something in the output. As you can see, Copilot Camp rocks, and we are able to get the reaction like. So we are able to actually customize some of the experiences we are providing in Teams by just using app.feedback loop. Another thing you can add is the AI label, which automatically comes in every agent response. But there are some other capabilities like adding adaptive cards, for example. I already have card edit in my app, and you'll be able to create that using our labs. And you should be able to make it work by just following the labs right away. But by using predicted say command, and I'm just going to uncomment this. What predicted say command does is actually, instead of just replying in text format, you are able to customize the format of the agent, so the response of the agent format. So in that case, what I'm doing here is I'm using the create response card I already created. This is just a really basic adaptive card that I'm using for the citation, just to make sure that I get some more information about the data behind the scene. And in addition to that, in the activity entities, I have more than just the AI label. AI label is enabled in my adaptive card, but also I have sensitivity label where I define that this is a confidential information. We are sharing people's CVs, resumes, so make sure that you don't share this outside of the conversation. So these and some of the other additional capabilities, you can just do it easily using Teams AI Library. I'll just save this. And then I will ask something similar, but let's ask something different just to make sure that our agent is capable of answering questions other than just .NET. Okay, I'll ask, can you suggest, and this question is also available in our labs, can you suggest any candidates for a senior developer position with 7+ year experience that requires Japanese speaking? Let's see. For that, you should actually have a look at the resumes we have behind the scene just to make sure that we have that person. But what I'm expecting is more advanced citation. Here, as you can see, the previous citation is a bit limited. If you want to customize the experience the way agent replies, then you can create your own adaptive card. And here we have some candidate suggestions. And if you click on the citation, you're able to see the full resume suggested for you. And in addition to that, instead of having only AI generated, we also have confidential label available in our answer. And we also have thumbs up and thumbs down button at the bottom. So this is all I wanted to share. I know this was quick, but if you go to Copilot Developer Camp, you will be able to build all of those from scratch by just following the build path labs. And if you have any questions, you can drop it in the chat. I'll be in the session to continue answering your questions.